Look which dirty rhino passed the Russian dossier to the FBI. The entire Russian collusion narrative is beginning to boomerang on the Democrats, and it may end up taking down some prominent Republicans along the way. Yesterday, we reported that it's now been confirmed that Hillary Clinton and the DNC both helped to fund the so-called Russian dossier that was filled with lies and fabrications about President Trump. The bombshell news shook the political world, and we have yet to see what the full fallout from it will be. However, what we do know is that there were Republicans involved with the ordeal. The Washington Post report released late Tuesday night revealed that an unknown Republican initially funded the research by former British spy Christopher Steele, before the law firm Perkins Coie and the Clinton campaign continued funding his work through Fusion GPS. The Clinton campaign paid Perkins Coie $5.6 million in legal fees from June 2015 to December 2016, according to campaign finance records, and the DNC paid the firm $3.6 million in legal and compliance consulting since November 2015, though it's impossible to tell from the filings how much of that work was for other legal matters and how much of it related to Fusion GPS. Additionally, we know that Rhino Senator John McCain was the one who passed the dossier along to the FBI in January because he admitted as much, the Daily Mail reported. Sworn Donald Trump enemy John McCain admitted Wednesday that he passed the dossier of claims of a Russian blackmail plot against the president-elect. The Arizona senator issued a public statement amid mounting questions of his exact role in the affair, and how a document riddled with errors and unverifiable claims came to be published. "Late last year, I received sensitive information that has since been made public," he said. Upon examination of the contents, and unable to make a judgment about their accuracy, I delivered the information to the director of the FBI. That has been the extent of my contact with the FBI or any other government agency regarding this issue. Further, we also know that former FBI Director James Comey attempted to use the bogus dossier full of whacked-out allegations as leverage to keep his job within the FBI, an effort that proved to be an abysmal failure. Again, the full fallout from this ordeal has yet to be seen. However, the more we learn about this ridiculous dossier, the more evident it becomes that it was created just to take down the president. Thank God they were unsuccessful. We'll be right back.